Do not buy this 2023 Honda CR-V. Don't do it, even though it's been redesigned this year. It's longer, it's wider, more cargo space, more tech options. Don't buy it if you are price sensitive, care about standard all-wheel drive, and are looking for an off-road trim. This doesn't have it. Let me explain. Now, I should note the positives do outweigh the negatives, and I will go over some of the highlights of what makes this new this year. So, price sensitivity. The MSRP range between 32 and 40 grand. So the base MSRP right around $32,000. That is more expensive than the following vehicles: CX-5, Sportage, Tucson, Rogue, Tiguan, RAV4, Forester, Escape, Equinox, Terrain, and Outlander. Just to name almost all of them. A couple that are more expensive than the CR-V, the Jeep Cherokee, and the Bronco Sport. Again, the positives do outweigh the negatives. The CR-V comes in four trim levels: EX, EXL, Sport, and Sport Touring. I have the Sport Touring and the hybrid version of that. Now, front-wheel drive is standard. All-wheel drive, optional, and that's gonna be a big negative for people who are looking for that quality. The thing is, only a couple of them that I found have all-wheel drive as standard. That's the Subaru Forester and the CX-5. So, is it a big deal? It is available, but not standard. Last but not least, there is no off-road trim available on the CR-V. They don't have it. Do you even need it? They got the all-wheel drive option, already mentioned that. If you want an off-road trim, go with the Trail Sport option package. That's something Honda has been introducing lately. They have it on the Passport. So if you want to stay in the Honda family, go with the Passport if you want an off-road trim or maybe the Ridgeline, but maybe they'll add that in the future. Not sure just yet, but if you are looking for an off-road trim in the compact crossover segment, maybe look closer at the RAV4 or any of the Subarus. I feel like I have to say it again, the pros absolutely outweigh the cons with the 2023 CR-V. After all, it has been named a Moto Trend SUV of the Year in the past, a couple of times. Maybe it'll get there again in the future. In the meantime, here are some highlights from my week with the CR-V. And a big welcome back to Everyman Driver. I'm Dave Erickson alongside Peanut. And today I'm gonna give you an overview and quick look inside and out of this 2023 Honda CR-V with all the details and specs on everymandriver.com. Let's get started. So a couple of engine options for you. You've got the turbocharged 1.5 liter four cylinder. That'll get you 190 horsepower, 179 pound-feet of torque with a CVT, front-wheel drive, standard, all-wheel drive, optional. Then you have the 2-liter, that's 204 horsepower, 247 pound-feet of torque. I have the hybrid version of the 2-liter, and my fuel economy, 40 miles per gallon city, 34 in the highway. This has different drive modes as well: normal, eco, snow, and sport. Mine has the sport because it's available in the higher trims. One of the benefits of that fully redesigned chassis is more cargo space. Now, there are a couple ways you can open the cargo here. There's a button on the inside, there's one on the key fob. You can press a button below the Honda logo. If the key fob is on you, I'd love this feature. I'm glad more and more cars are doing this. A nice, easy kick underneath the bumper. It comes on up. So behind the back row, super spacious. 36.5 cubic feet of cargo volume, which is 3 cubic feet larger than the outgoing model. So this is enormous, one of the best in the class. Folding those seats down, then you increase it to 76 and change. So plenty of cargo for this compact SUV. And when you're ready to walk away, you can press a button here along the edge, or like before, hands are full, nice kick underneath, it closes automatically, you can walk away and no worries whatsoever. Super easy. Barely an inconvenience. Here's a look at the spaciousness in the back seat. First of all, look how wide open that door comes, nearly 90 degrees. It might actually be 90 degrees, but look at this. That's my position as a driver up front. I'll give you my position here behind the driver, but I got two car seats back here, and look how much space that is. That is so much better than some of the other compacts that I've experienced in the past. This makes it super easy to put the kids in there without them being jammed up with their leg room. So that's great for the car seats. Now I'm gonna get in there and show you what it looks like for having a full-size adult in the back seat. Here we go. Now again, my position as a driver up front. I would have no problem sitting back here on a road trip if I had to and I wasn't driving. Here's my knees behind here, I'm 5'11". Headroom is great too, plenty of comfort. You know, this is nice. This is what it should be. This is why it is one of the best-selling vehicles in America for the last, what, 30 decades? 30 decades? 30 years, 3 decades. For an MSRP range between 32 and 40 grand, I would not hesitate recommending the Honda CR-V. Other competitors include the RAV4, the Sorento, CX-5, the Tucson, as well as the Forester, just to name a few. Until next time, I'm Dave Erickson. Thanks so much for watching. All the details and specs on everymandriver.com. Adios. One final note, if you are in the market for a new vehicle soon, great. Connect with your local dealership and price and test drive at least 3 different vehicles. A vehicle's strengths and weaknesses can only be discovered when you are behind the wheel. My reviews can be good, but you need to test drive these yourself. Visit quotes.everymandriver.com, select the make, model, and your zip code, and you'll get invoice pricing in your area on those vehicles. Shop smarter with price quotes at quotes.everymandriver.com.
Thanks for watching.
Please click subscribe
and give us a thumbs up.
See you next time.